The Lord bless you. You are welcome to Solution Service once again this morning. It is my earnest prayer that every good things of life that God has designed and desire will continue to manifest in your life. In the mighty name of Jesus. This morning we are talking on swimming in favor. Swimming in favor. As we are in the season of favor, the only way by which you can swim in the ocean of favor is to learn how to use your mouth. God has opened the door of favor, and he will allow that favor to flow continually into your life. But that you have a role to play, and that is your mouth must connect with, you know, what with your expectation. I want us to just look at about 6-7 things, benefits of the usage of your mouth that will determine how much of favor that you enjoy. And the more you know how to use it, the more of this blessing you will enjoy. Number one is that your word determines the degree of your freedom. Your word determines the degree of your freedom. Matthew chapter 12, verse 37. Matthew 12, 37. It says, "For by your word thou shalt be justified, and by thy word thou shalt be condemned." Two things there that Jesus said your word can do for you. He said either your word justifies you or your word condemns you. So some people will be condemned by the word they speak. Others will be justified by the word they speak. And I think it is better to be justified by the word than to be condemned by the word. And that is the reason why those words that will bring condemnation will never come out of your mouth again. I decree into your life that your mouth will be empowered to speak the word that will justify, the word that will bring blessing into your life in the mighty name of Jesus. If you believe it, let your amen be better. Number two, your word determines your progress in life. Your word determines your progress in life. Proverbs chapter 6, verse number 2. Proverbs chapter 6, verse number 2. It said, "Thou art snared with the words of thy mouth. Thou hast taken with the word of your mouth." Word determine progress. It is possible for a man to be snared by the words of his mouth. You will not be snared by your word in the name of Jesus. A number of people has entered into trap by what they say. A good number of people have walked out of trap by what they say. And by the power of the Almighty God, your word will bring you out of snare in the name of Jesus. Let me hear somebody say, "I am going higher." Let me hear somebody say, "I am going higher." Let me hear somebody say, "I am getting better. Every day of my life, I am going higher. I am getting better." What failed to work for others will work in my life because my case is different. In the mighty name of Jesus. If you believe it, say better. Amen. Number three things that your word do for you is that it puts angel on assignment for you. Each time you speak, angels are waiting to hear something from you and to accomplish what you say. Ecclesiastes chapter 5, verse number 6. Ecclesiastes chapter 5, verse number 6. It said, Suffer not thy mouth to cause thy flesh to sin. Neither say thou before the angel that it was an error. Wherefore should God be angry at thy voice and destroy the works of thy hand? He said, don't allow your mouth to cause you to sin, nor allow, your word to say anything error before an angel. Because each time you speak, there are angels that bring your word, work on what you say in order to bring it to manifestation. As soon as a word is uttered, angel pick them up and enforce them, whether they be negative or they are positive. That's why you need to also decree this morning, I will get better every day. Every good things of life that I have not seen hitherto, I will see them this month. I will build a house, I will live in it. I will buy my car and I will ride in it. I will live in good health. It will be well with me. Where others fail, I will succeed. Where others fall, I will stand tall. In the mighty name of Jesus, the power that pulled others down will not be strong enough to pull me down, because God is by my side and I will be victorious. In the mighty name of Jesus, I will end this year strong. I will end this year glorious. I will end this year powerful. In the mighty name of Jesus. If you believe it, say better, amen. Look to your neighbor, to your left and to your right, and say to them, look at me very well. Very soon you will resemble me again. Because I am going through the process of transformation. And very soon, I will get to perfection in the name of Jesus. Let me hear that amen again. Make that amen better. So shall it be for you in Jesus' name. What you have said is what the angel of the Lord is taking to God this morning. And they are bringing you consignment of blessing. In the mighty name of Jesus. Number 14 is that your word determines your well-being. Your word determines your well-being. Proverbs chapter 13, verse number 3. Proverbs 13:3. It said, he that keepeth his mouth, keepeth his life. But he that openeth wide his lip shall have destruction. The one who keep his mouth, keep his life. Ability to be able to speak the right word, bring preservations to your life. And so, as you speak good word, they bring you preservation. And that is the reason why you need to stop talking negative and stop talking about the big problem. My problem is very big. You don't have big problem. You have big God. Say to your neighbor, my God is far, far bigger than my trouble. My God is far, far bigger than my challenges. And whatever challenge that I'm having now, I will overcome them, because God will give me victory over all the challenges of life that I am seeing today. That thing that represents Goliath standing before me now, it will soon fall flat. Because as God back up David, he will back me up to cut off the head of my Goliath, and I will celebrate the victory of the Lord in the mighty name of Jesus. If you look forward to celebrate victory, shout hallelujah. The number 5 things that your word do for you, it bring peace into your home, peace into your marriage, peace all about you, Proverbs chapter 14, verse number 1. Proverbs 14, verse number 1. It says, every wise woman buildeth a house, but the foolish plucketh it down with her hand. And then verse chapter 15, verse 1, says, a soft answer trusted away wrath, but grievous word stir up anger. What determines the amount of peace you enjoy is by the reason of the word you speak. War are triggered by words. In fact, before any physical war, there is always a trait of war. Almost in all cases, before people fight themselves, there is always exchange of war. They will abuse themselves, they will threaten themselves before they go into action. And if you don't want trouble, when somebody is looking for trouble, you can excuse yourself. Say, I will slap you. Say, we don't need to get to that level. It is not up to that. Let's forget about the trouble. Let's live in peace. Sometimes you think, well, we will fight and I will win this battle. Sometimes you may even win the battle, but you go with a lot of injuries. Consider yourself going to work and one small boy or small girl trying to harass you and say, I will beat you up. You actually succeeded in beating the person up, but before you leave the place, he has torn the whole of your dress. So what is the essence? Sometimes your word determines how much of peace you enjoy. And as the Lord lives, you will continue to enjoy the peace of God. Amen. Say to your neighbor, I will enjoy peace. Amen. In every area of my life. Amen. The peace of God is my portion. Because I have the Prince of Peace as my God. In every aspect of my life, it will be peace, peace, peace. In the name of Jesus. If you believe it, let your amen be better. Amen. Number six, things that your word does for you is that your word determines your victory. 1 Samuel chapter 17, as you read from verse 26 to 45. 1 Samuel 17, from verse 26 to 45. It is a popular story of David and Goliath. Now, Goliath came and threatened the army of Israel, and everybody ran into hiding. But when David came to the scene, the man who have faith in God and who knows that the Almighty God will always back up the word of his people, he decided to speak against Goliath. And so when Goliath was speaking all his errors and all his trouble, David was speaking righteously. Now, first, David began in verse 26. When he heard Goliath speaking, he said to the people, what shall be done to the man who deal with this Goliath and remove this reproach from Israel? And they said to him, the king has promised that whoever will face this Goliath and defeat him will become an in-law to the king. And his household, his father's house, we no longer pay tax again. He said, if that is the case, I'm going for it. I am going for it. David was brought before the king. The king looked at it and said, boy, you are too small for this task. He said to the king, I am more than able. He said, I am more than able. He said, don't look me with a small eye. I am more than this. Help me tell your neighbor, I am more than this. Say it as if you mean it. I am more than this. Don't look me with a small eye. I may be small outside, but great God lives inside of me. And so I am big inside. If you look me small, you will be disappointed. Because my God will prove himself on my behalf. Hallelujah. When David showed up to Goliath, Goliath was embarrassed. They are, where do you think you are coming? Do you think they have sent you to a dog? I'm going to kill you. And I will give your head to the birds of the air to feed in. And David said to him, without sword in his hand, only sling and stone. He said, well, it is not my own head that will be cut off. It is not me that the bird will eat. It is you. Because today, God is going to deliver you into my hand. And I'm going to cut off your head. And I'm going to give it over to the birds of the air. And the whole world will know that there is a God that lives in Israel. Before that day was out, Goliath lost his head. That's why I'm believing God with you this morning. Everything that represents Goliath that has been terrorizing and intimidating your life, today they will lose their head. Everything that represents Goliath that has been troubling the peace of your family, that has been troubling the peace of your career, today they will lose their head. Every power that says you will not get to where God has ordained you to get to, today they shall be uprooted. They shall be scattered. In the mighty name of Jesus. The hand of the Lord is going to back you up. And is going to enforce your victory over your enemy. Those enemy that says they will kill you, you will be there at their funeral. You will outlive them. In the mighty name of Jesus. Those who are waiting for you to be disgraced, you will see them in their disgrace. They will see you in your honor. In the mighty name of Jesus. The power of the Almighty God will carry you above circumstances of life. What has pushed others and relegated them to one corner will bring you to the limelight. In the mighty name of Jesus. If you believe it, let your amen be better. Then number 7 is that your word determines your result in life. Your word determines your result. The result you have in life is in direct proportion to the word that you speak. Job chapter 6, verse 25. Job 6, verse 25. He said, how forcible are right words, but what does your argument reprove? How forcible are right words? Right words are forcible. What you can say, you know, each time you see things right and you are able to say them, you know, you get yourself into manifestation. The result you get in life is determined by the words of your mouth. If you go back to that Jeremiah chapter 1, you know, and verse 11, when God has said to Jeremiah, what did you see? He said, I see the rod of an almond tree. And the word of God said, you have seen right. You got it right. You are correct. And because you get it right, the result you get will also be right. Because you get it right, every impossibility how to get out of the way. Now, you may not understand what Jeremiah said he saw that day and he declared. Now, but when you read in Numbers chapter 17 in verse 8, you will find out that on the day when Korah, Dathan, Abiram confronted Moses, now Moses determined to prove to the world that God has sent him, and he asked that they bring a rod. And they brought a stick of an almond and they put it down. And the following morning, that rod produced leaf and it produced fruit. without getting to the ground, the tree that has been cut produce leaf and produce fruit overnight. Now, which means Jeremiah was saying, I see impossibilities becoming possible. I see opposition crumble. I see the challenges, those who want to prove them. I see God proving himself over my situation. And if there is something you must see and you must declare, is that God is proving himself in your situation. It never matter how challenging that situation may be. I am standing here to declare to you, God will prove himself over your situation. 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 In the mighty name of Jesus, say it with your mouth. God will prove himself over my situation. Say it 7 times. God will prove himself over my situation. 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 If you believe it, say it better. Amen. So if you ever want to enjoy favor, you must learn to speak it into your life. You have been given license to speak certain words into your life. And until you say them, you don't see them. Job chapter 38, verse 12. Job chapter 38, verse 12. He said, hast thou commanded the morning since thy days, and caused the day spring to know its place? Hast thou commanded the morning since thy days, and cause this day spring to know its place? It's a question to ponder and to walk with this morning. Have you ever commanded the morning? Which means you're supposed to command the morning. You're supposed to wake up in the morning and you command the day. You, Wednesday, 7th day of October 2015, you are bringing me favor. You are bringing me honor. You are bringing me lifting. In all that I'm going to undertake today, it will be successful. It will be well. Men and women will bring support into my life. Every support that I desire is going to come into my life. You are making declaration into the day. And when you declare the day, he said, you are telling the day spring to have their place. And everything will fall in place in your life. Hallelujah. Everything will fall in place in your life. And so if there is something you need to do this morning, and you need to connect, it's how to connect your word with what God has said about your life. If God has said, say ye to the righteous, it shall be well with them, then you need to declare it again and again. You need to reenact it again and again. If the word of God has said, be fruitful and multiply, you need to reenact it again and again. Say it, declare it, and you see the manifestation. If the word of God has said, I wish above all things that you prosper and be in health, you need to reenact it again and again. Everything standing on the way of my prosperity, you must get out, because I am destined to prosper. I am marked for prosperity. I am marked for lifting. The word of the Lord says, Blessed be God who is interested in the promotion of his servant. If God desire your promotion, nothing should stop you or make you stagnant in life. You need to say it again and again. You go into your office. As you are leaving your house, you are speaking. Every element working against my promotion, you are working against God.